Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the in-data project at Easterseals Crossroads, and today we're going to be taking a look at a utility called Web Captioner, which provides real-time captioning for events and other types of activities using artificial intelligence. So let's go ahead and take a look.
Hi, my name is Anna Leung. I'm an Assistive Technology Specialist at Easterseals Crossroads. Today I'm going to show you how to use Web Captioner. Web Captioner is a web-based tool that transcribes your speech instantly onto the computer screen. Please use a microphone to speak to your computer for best results. It is important to know that it only works in a Google Chrome web browser. I'm recording this video through Zoom video conference, and you can use Zoom in conjunction with Web Captioner too, so that your audience can hear and see your speech clearly. Now I'm going to share my computer screen with you. First, launch a Google Chrome web browser and then go to the website search field and type in webcaptioner.com. So webcaptioner.com. Hit enter and you will be brought to their website right away. A little bit lower on the screen, you'll find a blue rectangular button called Start Captioning. So once I click on it, you'll find a black screen and then another Start Captioning button at the lower right corner so that you can truly take your time and get yourself ready. So let me give you an example. Hi, my name is Anna, period. I'm glad that you joined me in this video, period. It is sunny and nice outside, period. I think I will take a walk outdoors soon, period. I have just hit another rectangular button in the same area called Stopped Captioning, and at that time it was in pink. So that you can take a break. When you're ready, you hit this Start Captioning button to resume your captioning. Let me show you the settings. In the lower right corner, there's a settings button. Click on it, and then it appears, it shows a few options, and there's another settings button. So I'm gonna click on that. You'll see a list of settings that you can change on the left panel. Under general, you can create an account with a username and password by selecting the sign in button. There's some other options, like some options to censor profane language, to change the volume, to use large navigation bar buttons, etc. You will also find a list of shortcuts. On the left, you will also find appearance settings. So select that. That will help you to change the caption settings. For example, you can change the text family. You can change the text color, text size, line height, letter spacing. You can also change the way you want to capitalize your words. You can make everything uppercase, or you can make each word the first letter to be capitalized, or you can just do what I did. You can just make the first letter of each sentence to be capitalized, and then you have to say period or question mark after each sentence, and then it will repeat all over again. You can also change the alignment by changing the horizontal alignment, vertical alignment. You can also change the background color and the text shadow. Another thing it's important to know is the language. By default, the spoken language is English, United States English, but you can also scroll down to find another language that you like to speak to. There are more than 40 languages and dialects for you to choose from. Last but not the least, I want to show you three important buttons in the settings button. So go back to the lower right corner, select settings. The first one is save transcript. You can save it into two different formats, the text file format or the Word document format. So I'm going to just close this one, go back to the settings button. And then the middle button, you can create a new window to do your captioning. The last one is you can clear the transcript. It means that you can manipulate your transcript by going back to the transcript, selecting anything, copying and pasting somewhere else, like in a Word document, in an edit box, or in a text field. That's it. That's your tech tip of the day. Thank you for watching.
That's your tech tip for this week. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.